Jet engine, jet snowboard. Winter sucks. It's freezing cold, everything is covered in slush and ice, the roads are terrible, and you need like 50 layers of clothing just to go outside. The only thing I like about winter is snowboarding. I love snowboarding, it's awesome. And when I'm not building lightsabers or power loaders, I try to get onto the slopes as often as possible. This year, I was super excited because I just got my new board. And then, lockdown 2.0, which means all the slopes are closed and can't really go snowboarding without slopes. Unless, cross-country snowboarding? Alright, obviously that doesn't work. But I think I've got an idea. I do work at Hacksmith Industries after all. Okay, it should be somewhere here. It's not there. Hey, Ben, where do we put the EDF bins? Ah! Yes! Jet engine, jet snowboard. This should actually be pretty simple. We've got the jet engine, we need to make a mounting bracket, put it on the snowboard, and that's it. Let's make it real. Okay, all the parts are mounted, so I'm gonna take it outside and give it a first test just to make sure it doesn't blow up or anything. And then if that goes well, it's gonna be time to ride it. This video is sponsored by Private Internet Access. When you go online, the number one tool you need in your arsenal is a trustworthy VPN. And the one I use and recommend is Private Internet Access. Oh, and if that name sounds familiar, you probably heard about it from my buddy Linus as well. PIA is also his favorite VPN. Private Internet Access offers complete digital privacy. All of your internet traffic goes through a secure VPN tunnel. Your IP address is hidden and your data is encrypted. Plus, it allows you to access a ton of geo-restricted content. You can use one subscription to protect up to 10 devices. That should handle your phone, tablet, laptop, desktop, your cat's laptop, and more. It's available on Windows, macOS, Android, and iOS. If you use the link below, you can subscribe for less than $3 a month. That's 77% off. And Private Internet Access will also give you 3 extra months for free. If you're not completely satisfied, there's a 30-day money-back guarantee. So what are you waiting for? Get your Private Internet Access subscription today and unlock more content. Okay. We'll be right back. Okay, that was a lot of fun. But as you might have noticed, I wasn't going that fast. And that's because this thing is insanely hard to ride. You see, this board actually has an inherent design flaw. And that's the fact that the center of pressure on the board is actually in front of the center of gravity. What that means is the board is inherently unstable and wants to keep turning. So as soon as I start turning, it just wants to spin in circles, which means I've got to actively balance it the entire time. The possible solution is to either move the jet engine up, which would either burn my leg or I need some kind of weird pole to hold it, or to put a lot of weight on my front leg, which makes it really, really exhausting. So with a lot of practice, there's no reason I shouldn't be able to get going 100 kilometers an hour, but I'm just not that good of a snowboarder, and we don't really have that much time in the day. Let me walk you through how this works. Back here, we've got a KingTech K320G, which will actually produce 32 kilograms of thrust. The engine actually spins at over 100,000 RPM, and the exhaust is over 850 degrees Celsius. Pretty ridiculous. In the middle here, we've got our gas tank full of diesel, and underneath the engine, we've actually got a pump and some electronics to allow me to control the entire thing. This trigger here is fully proportional. So when I turn the engine on and I give it full throttle, it'll actually spin up to maximum power, but I can control that by letting off a little bit. If you'd like to see the full schematic diagram, make sure to check out our maker.io link in the description below. I want to give it another try. Let's go out there and see what I can do. Okay guys, I did my best, but this thing has an insanely steep learning curve. It's really hard to ride. But that's the fun thing with one day builds, is everything might look good on paper, but you really don't know what's gonna happen until you give it a try, and this was a really fun attempt. So if you'd like to see us do more one day builds, make sure to let us know in the comments, and make sure to subscribe. I'll see you on the slopes, or the flats, or whatever.